Hello and how's it going? Zach D Productions here, and I am here for a movie review for you guys. Now, I made a community post not too long ago saying that I would be reviewing the rest of the Spider-Man films. I just have this review to do, and then the review for No Way Home, which is actually going to be a re-review because I did review the movie like a month or so after it came out. But now that the hype has kind of slowly died down from No Way Home, and I feel like now I can give you a less biased review for Spider-Man No Way Home. And also the movie will be almost, it'll be a year old this December, which is really hard to believe. But for this review, I'll be reviewing Spider-Man Far From Home. And I would say that this is one of the more unique Spider-Man films. This is, of course, the second Spider-Man film in the MCU. Tom Holland is back as Spider-Man, aka Peter Parker. And the reason I say that this is one of the most unique Spider-Man films is because this doesn't really feel like a Spider-Man film. Like, when you watch the film, it's really different compared to any other Spider-Man films, you know, including the ones with Tobey Maguire and Andrew Garfield. And I feel like for a while, that's why I was very dismissive towards the Tom Holland Spider-Man films, is because they're very different from Tobey and Andrew's sagas of Spider-Man, you could say. But I will say that this is a very good movie. It is. I do think it's solid. Now, I wouldn't put it up there as the best Spider-Man film or anything, but it is good for what it is. And I honestly do think it's a step up from Spider-Man Homecoming. But one thing that gives Homecoming the upper hand, in my opinion, is I do think that it has a better villain. I do prefer the Vulture in Homecoming than Mysterio, who is the villain in this movie. But don't get me wrong, I do like Mysterio quite a bit in this movie. And one of the reasons that this movie does stand out and why it's very different as well is, well, if you're well aware of Spider-Man and if you're a Spider-Man fan, I'm sure you're well aware of the fact that the setting and the location for Spider-Man has always been New York City. But most of this film actually does not take place in New York City. Basically, Peter Parker goes on this field trip with his classmates, and I believe he visits places like Italy, I believe, and also the UK, I think. But yeah, so obviously that goes along with the title Spider-Man Far From Home, and that's of course why they called it that, because he's far from home, of course, far from New York. And that is definitely one of the things that makes this movie stand out and make it different in comparison to the rest. How they basically explore all these places. And I would say visually, this movie is a lot more interesting than Homecoming as well. And of course, that probably has a lot to do with Mysterio, you know, with all his abilities. And of course, if Mysterio's involved, you know, it's going to be visually pretty interesting. And, you know, I remember even back in the Tobey Maguire days of Spider-Man, I've always wanted to see Mysterio in a live-action Spider-Man film. And of course, we got him right here in this movie. So basically the story is, well, again, Peter Parker goes on this field trip with his friends, Ned and MJ and all of them. And it's kind of like Spider-Man 2 from Sam Raimi in a sense. Basically in the sense of Peter Parker wanting to balance two lives. Not that Spider-Man is wanting to give up being who he is in this movie, but, you know, you could tell that he wants to spend time with his friends on this field trip, but he's also being assigned to missions by Nick Fury as Spider-Man. You know, he's, of course, on this team with Nick Fury, and also Mysterio is involved as well, and he wants Peter Parker to believe that he's on his side, and it's, of course, revealed at the end that he's not. And, of course, we knew right from the get-go that Mysterio was up to no good. I mean, come on now. And Mysterio, yeah, interesting villain for sure, and you know, the things that he can do, pretty fascinating. Of course, you know, he has these like these illusion abilities, and those aspects of the film are very fun to watch, you know, especially when, you know, he's basically got Spider-Man trapped in a corner, and you know, he sees himself in a mirror, and all these different Spider-Men just go after him, basically. And then he gets hit by a train, and it's really fun to watch, and you know, just how he tricks him and everything. It's pretty mind-blowing, actually. So, yeah, I do think it's a cool movie overall. I do appreciate the ending of this movie as well, you know, with the swinging scene with Spider-Man actually swinging in New York. And I feel like they put that in the movie to make up for the lack of the New York City scenes in this movie. And I will say that that scene was very cool. I'd say that that's one of the probably one of the coolest Spider-Man swinging scenes of the Tom Holland trilogy so far anyways. But yeah, the emotional moments, it's all really well done here, I'd say. And of course, Mysterio, before he dies, spoiler alert, he records this message, basically revealing Spider-Man's identity, which of course leads right into the next film, No Way Home. And I will of course talk about No Way Home in my review for that. But yeah, so there is a lot to like with this movie. Again, I don't think it's perfect. It's not the best Spider-Man film, but for what it is, it's good. It's a pretty good movie, I'd say. So if I were to give this movie a score, I'd probably give it an 8 out of 10. So yeah, very good one. I'd say check it out if you haven't checked it out yet. So that's my review for Spider-Man: Far From Home. Let me know what you think. Do you like this movie? Have you seen this movie? Are you a Spider-Man fan? Feel free to let me know. So on that note, thanks for watching. Have a good one.